Heyo! Hail and fail is today's motto, because I realized I recorded a lot of stuff and I didn't turn on my microphone. Which is awesome news, because that means I get to do it all over again. I thought about making a soundtrack and just dubbing over everything. And considering the fact that everything had gone very, very swimmingly indeed, that was very tempting. However, I can't really bring myself to doing that. So I'm gonna try to speed play it and see if I can do it just as well or even better this time. Now, what I did last time was I successfully invaded Bremen. Bremen and Hamburg Bremen and Hamburg are currently involved in an independence war. So I'm gonna see if I can't sneak it. I'm gonna try that. And shortly afterwards, we're gonna go for Sweden. So yeah. Strap in tight, guys, because this is going to be exciting! Well, as exciting as this game can be. It's a rather slow burn when you think about it. Anywho, anything here I want to spend my money on? No, customs, public customs. No, I want to save up for more legalism, I think. And, woohoo, shipbuilding. No, we're waiting for more military organization, which should come about fairly quickly. Other than that, we're still desperate. Let's see, last time I could not manage to fabricate a claim here in time. So I sent him down to fabricate a claim here instead, as soon as I started the war with Sweden. And lo and behold, shortly afterwards he gave me a claim on Brandenburg. Which probably isn't going to happen this time though, knowing my luck. So, without further ado, let's declare war before we call up our armies. We've made that mistake a few times. And I'm looking to secure Bremen. Yep. Now, one painful lesson I learned last time was that I inherit his independence war. So we're going to see how we deal with that. So last time I disbanded my armies and sent them home before the war was actually over. That was a bit of a mistake, so I'm going to try to avoid that mistake this time. Also, this time I'm going to leave behind these men and get them to go with these guys. So I think I can actually fit most of my army on these ships otherwise. Come on! People living on these islands are pretty rough people. Both in game and in reality. So they should be good to have in the upcoming war. And you guys can go there. And then we shall see what we shall see. Anybody I'm forgetting? I don't think so. I want to get as many people as possible in that first wave in order to secure. I can't wait to be rid of that from my domain. This is so pointless! Also, I'm gonna see if I can deal with this this Gavelkind succession a bit more successfully than I have been. Okay. Whoa. That's a lot more ships than I need there. And you guys. And you guys. I always forget to move that guy. Ah, you're absolutely full, aren't you? Yep, you are. Let's see if I can screw up anything else here. Merchants. Oh, you can go to sea. There we go. Okay. Keep merging it. And come on. Make it snappy. And just let's head down there. Because like I said, I want to move the whole army in at once, because I don't want to risk. They are fully mobilized, so I don't have any... There's no element of surprise there. So there's really no reason for me to rush this in any way, other than I have to beat the Lord of the Land to the victory, but I think that'll be fine. At least it was the last time I played. They can't possibly fit all those soldiers, so we're gonna see how many they can actually fit. And then we're gonna come down here. Come on. Am I still playing at speed 1? It's not the way I usually do things. Really? That's it? That means we do like this. And then we split off a small fleet. Go there. And you get the boat there. And then you come along. Then we all go down here. And it's going to be glorious! Glorious, I tell you. Don't you guys worry, I have not forgotten my promise to invade Sweden. As I have the deleted Let's Plays to prove, although without any commentary track on them. Thanks for pointing that out to me almost immediately. Apart from ruining my evening, which did, because this pissed me off to no end, it at least allowed me to correct this before I go on holiday. So I'm going to try to get as much recorded as possible tonight, so that you'll have some episodes while I'm away for the week. I'm headed off to sunny Spain with my family, which will be glorious. I have decreed it to be so, and it shall be glorious indeed. Ragnar, wow. Strictly speaking, you shouldn't be leading troops here. Cool. Auto-balance. Anything though, you should be leading this one yourself. Okay. Is there any way to sort of make him the leader of this? So if I do. Whoa. That was not what I wanted to do. Try to figure this out. Okay, that made him go away. Okay. We'll do it like this. I think that is a good way to do things. Probably do... yeah. Exactly. Okay, let's see how that works out. I have no idea what's gonna happen now. Anyway, I'm not gonna wait for the last 200 guys. I am, however, gonna just storm ashore and see how that works out for me. Guys, get down there. Whoops. Get on the boats. And there we go. And get in here and we will see. Yep, Marina is very much in charge. Yeah, and this is just shattering them, isn't it? A great surprise there. Oh. Your experience in matters of war has increased, and there are many things you will do differently in future battles. What will you focus on? I will focus on. I like unpredictable leader, that seems funny. But movement speed. Ooh. Being fast. I think that could be good. I'm not sure if it affects speed on and off boats, but. Nah. Yeah, we killed 849 and lost 161. I'll count that as a victory. And we're ready to start the invasion. Let's see. Yep, it was me. Organizer and heavy infantry leader. Good. Good, 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 good. Merge it up. Over the shore. Oops. Pretty sure I can go now. Yep, it's go time. Now we need to clear out this. Of course. Natürlich, meine kleine Freund aus Norwegen. Ah, Bremen is mine. Ooh, 740. Still, that's a 10-to-1 ratio. I'll take it. Could follow him and wipe him out. Ah. There we go. That's 100 men down. 200 men down. 300 men down. No, that's about 300 men down. Ooh, stressed. That's not good. That's not good at all. Should probably hold a good hunt or something once I'm done with these wars. Losing a lot of manpower. Shouldn't be losing this much manpower. Come on. Get her done. Ah, 40% done. Ah, here we go again. 600 men. Oh well, that was that war. And here we go again. Hi there. Remember me? And I got Craven. Thanks. So already this is off to a pretty much worse start than I had the last time. Last time I was... not sure if I got brave, but at least I didn't cock it up and get stressed and craven. You tool! Gonna get all your vassals upset with you. Look, Liege is craven, -5. Craptacular. Oh well. That's. Ah, there we go. Do I finish the siege or do I break it off? I break it off. Accept. There we go. Now, what needs to happen is I need to go. Need to go there. Oh, actually, I need to destroy that army. That's what I need to do. So I'm just gonna cross this river here, see? I can't possibly go wrong, can I? Oh, most of the army was completely disorganized before I got there. That's a shame. I lost 10 men. So we're gonna split our force. And Ragnar, you useless, useless man. Why the hell do you become cowardly? That is such a non-Viking way to do things. Go there. Get some leaders in here. Ah, and you're not even leading your army in here now? Well, that shall have to be remedied. Come on, man. Up in front you go. Wipe out, siege it up, and come on, Reinhard, you can do this. I think there's an event for getting rid of Craven even after you get it. Hopefully I can trigger it. Because I really don't want to be Craven. Okay, split the force again. This time, splitting it into 1,000 strong units. If anybody's curious as to why I'm doing it like this, it's basically that I want to destroy as much army as possible. See? He keeps doing shit like this. And then split you off. And split you off. It's actually a super effective way of getting rid of potential enemies. Also, it's very cheap war score. Although it doesn't, let's see. Yeah, that doesn't get me any war score, but it should demoralize him quickly and get him back to the negotiating table to end the war, because I don't really want to spend time sieging out every single holding of his. That'll just be extremely tedious. So let's see. There they go. You go up there. You can stay there. You can destroy this. Okay. That's just about that. Put Einar in charge of that army. Now we wait. Mm-hmm. He's at war with two of his counts, I think. Yeah, and if I remember correctly, he's gonna lose it. My namesake, and that will not do. So I'll give him some money for now, and see if that helps. See? Here he goes again. Keeps pulling that shit. You split off like so, and split off like so. You go there, and you go there. Maybe the AI can be actually tricked into surrender completely if you do it like this. See what he has to say for himself. Ooh. I'm proud of her. You're not even related to me, are you? Why am I raising you so well? Probably because I want you to get betrothed with... God damn it. probably wasting my efforts there. Ooh. Somebody else I should be teaching a thing or two about life. You. I should definitely be educating you. Okay. Come on, this has to end. Untouched armies and holdings. I'm not sure about untouched armies. Where are those armies? This training ground has been built. Cool. Let's build ourselves something else. Castle shipyard for more ships. I do seem to have enough ships to keep everybody going, so I'd rather go for the... Can't build better castle town. Barracks? Yeah, let's go for barracks. Slowly sieging them down. Who are you? Okay. Just some random beggar, huh? Oh well. Let's speed it up to level 4. Level 3, I mean. Let's get this done. I'm sieging this one faster than that one. That's what... That's what you get for having a bishopric as your capital. Ooh. Count Lothar of Oldenburg is trying to usurp my title. Chancellor Bishop Olaf is supposedly traveling around Bremen trying to find both documentation and supporters to help him legitimize the claimant's title. I need to do something about make him disappear, try and bribe him. I'll make him disappear. Ah, I succeeded. Good. Not really sure why I lose piety for that being a pagan and all, but hey. That's how we roll, I guess. Are you about ready to accept the inevitable? Untouched armies and holdings, okay. If you say so. Oh, lost my marshal. It's a shame. Find myself a new marshal then. Now this guy seems competent enough. Whatever you're doing, stop it and go up here. Barely making money. Huh. See one of those guys rebelling against you? Yep, he was. Pretty sure. Wovjemtland, yep, that's 103. Good on ya, mate. Ah. Improves economy. Good going. I will definitely adopt his policies. I agree, I need my economy improved. Come on, break him down. Yep, there's that thing done. 75, really? That's all you got for me? 75? Ah. He's willing to settle. No more claim for you. So, merge and stand down. Is that really all I have? No, I've got 2 units of that. I wonder where the others went. Oh yeah, all the boats. Cancel. I'll split off. Total of 10. And the rest of them can stand down. Come on. No retinues, no special units. Good. Merge, stand down. Yep, there they are. So you guys get on the boats and head on back. And there we go, and you guys can stand up. Yep. So, somebody said that if I land my other sons, that'll get taken out of the equation. Now, that might actually be true. Problem is right now, the kingdom is weighted so high that the only thing Ivar will inherit is the kingdom, a jarldom, and 3 counties, Trøndelag, Vestisland, and Færøyene. Vestisland, really. This guy, on the other hand, will get Trøndelag, the county of Nordland, and the barony of Stenungsholm, and then this guy gets 5 counties. And he already has 3 counties. That'll bring him up to 8 counties. This guy has... wow. But if I give him a jarldom, that should severely restrict what he can get. So I want to make him the Jarl of Jämtland, I think. Yeah, why not? Whose jail are you in? So if we do... if I create the Duchy of Jämtland... yes. And then we give that to this guy. That should probably severely reduce his inheritance. Yep, now he's down to 2 counties. And he's up to a bunch. And then he gets a jarldom. And so I need to give him a crap jarldom as well. So I'm going to do that while I'm at it, or I'm going to wait. No, I'm going to wait until... yeah. And I have to get rid of this. Who should get that? I think some guy named Bob will probably do well there. You? Cruel, cynical, slothful. We should get along pretty good. Yep. 47 years old. Yeah, I'll grant you a land title, and I'll get you... before I get you anything, I'm going to create my own little mini vassals down there. Check the inheritance again, just for fun. Now he stands to get 2 counties. He stands to get a bunch of counties. 3 and a barony. Do I hold a barony? Where does he inherit the barony from? Somebody else? Probably. Yeah, he's his own daughter's... Oh, that's a temple. Stenvik's home, isn't that in Tundlag? Excuse me, I'm just confusing myself in a lot there. Okay. Huh. Why the hell? Hang on. Come here. Okay, so it'll upset them. Can I plot to get it? Barony of Semicolon. Intrigue. Nope. I can't. Can plot to kill my own grandson, that's interesting. Okay, so for some reason my second oldest son stands to inherit that barony because it apparently is his vassal. Okay, and this guy inherits three counties, kingdom and jarldom. If I give this guy a random jarldom, I have to take away that jarldom, leave him with three counties. Seems legit. Anyway, you court. Opinion. Apparently, you like me more. Why do you like me more? Doesn't matter. You like me more. You get, and you're younger. Grant you land the title. You can have the county of Bremen. Enjoy. So that helps. And that's it for the first episode of this redo. All things considered, it went slightly worse in that I'm now Craven, which sucks ass, but hey, what can you do? Next episode, we will tear Sweden a new one, hopefully. So let's see, they have 7,000 men. I have 8,000 men, plus my retinue, 9,000. So we'll see. We will indeed see. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys around. Cheers.